In the energy sector today, taking a look at the September crude oil contract, which is in the midst of a two-day fall right now, finishing a little bit better off the lows. But on the upside today, we were up about 1% at 71.96, but we ended up losing that 71 handle, getting all the way down to 69.19, which was down 2.9%, finishing the day just a little bit better than down 1% at about 70.59 or so. In just 2 days, we're working on the worst week for the price of crude oil since March 15th, down over 3% at this point on the week. You got pandemic effects built into this, the potential for slowing demand based on the number of cases from the Delta variant, especially in some of the southern states like Texas and Florida, causing this idea that demand will weaken as people get out less and less. And of course, new mask mandates, some travel restrictions, mask mandates specifically in a place like New York City, where you now need vaccines, proof of vaccine to go to indoor events like concerts, even dining in restaurants, according to the edict by the mayor. But also that may slow just some overall movement and slow the demand for gasoline products and subsequently crude oil. Although in refinery utilization, which we'll get tomorrow, the demand still seems rather high, but there's been overall pressure on the commodity sector based on what's going on in China with the Chinese battle with their own tech sector. The Chinese government versus the tech sector within China is kind of affecting the potential of global growth with things like antitrust probes, with data security concerns that the Chinese government has stressed, as well as gaming issues that they have with their own gaming companies on the children of China. One Chinese government-owned publication calling it opium to children and saying their addiction is going to hurt their growth in the future. This has affected the overall commodity complex, and crude oil not immune to that.